Hi BCom students, I hope this video will help you to have a short revision on computation of income from other sources. Myself, Dr. A. Devi, Assistant Professor, Department of Commerce, KCS Kasinadar College of Arts and Science. Income from other sources. IFOS under Income Tax Act is the head of the income under which the unidentified income and the income which is not covered under other four heads of income of an individual, such as salary income, house property income, business income and capital gain, are treated as income under IFOS. To say it simply, தனி மனித வருமானத்தின் மற்ற நான்கு தலைப்புகளில் அடங்காத வருமானங்கள் IFOS-இல் வருமானமாக ட்ரீட் பண்ணப்படும். Here is the format for computation of income from other sources. There are different incomes or cover under this head as a taxable income. The remaining slides will tell you what are all the incomes will come under IFOS and how it should be treated as a taxable income under IFOS. Income under IFOS and its treatment. First one, dividend income. Any dividend income received by an assessee is taxable under the head IFOS. However, the dividend received from foreign company and cooperative societies alone are taxable income. Any dividend received from an Indian company or from units of UTI are not taxable. It is completely exempted. Bank commission on collection of taxable dividend or allowable deductions. Next, casual income. It is an income which is earned by chance. Example, card games, lottery income, income from betting, crossword puzzles, etc. Income earned is to be taken as taxable income, not the income received, because the TDS is applicable for this kind of income. The TDS rate is 30%. Casual income la assessee evlo panam sambadicharo adha da taxable income a eduthukanum. Avar kaiyila vaangna panatha nama taxable income a eduthukakoodathu. 30% TDS pidikiradanaala kaiyila vaangra panam 70%, appadina avar 100% evlo earn pannirkaarnu kandupidichi podanum. When amount 1 are given to lottery and betting on horse races, they represents gross amounts. Grossing up is not needed in such case. When amount received is given, they represent net amount. In such case, grossing up is required at the applicable rate, that is 30%. Grossing up is not required when the income is less than Rs. 10,000 in case of lotteries and Rs. 5,000 in case of income from betting on horse races. The formula for grossing up is gross amount is equal to net amount into 100 divided by 70. Interest income. Interest on securities are treated as taxable income under IFOS. Securities are nothing but debt, papers, debentures, bond, etc. Here, the securities are classified into government securities and non-government security. Under government security, certain list of securities which are completely exempted in computation of interest income under section 10 of 15. And the securities which are not under the list of 10 or 15 are treated as an taxable securities, and non-government securities are classified into tax-free commercial security and less tax commercial security. The reason for classification is here the income earned to be taken as an taxable income, not income received. The TDS is applicable at the rate of 10% for interest income, and here we will see how the grossing up is to be computed for each of these categories of securities. For government security, no tax is deducted on government securities, hence interest on government security shall not be grossed up. Government security ya gross up panna venda, adu government security ya appdin kandupidikkiradhukku the word government will be there in the security name. Then interest on non-government securities, less tax commercial securities is to be grossed up only when the net amount is given. If gross amount is given, we need not to gross it up. Only when in the case of net amount is given, there the grossing up is required. Whereas in tax-free commercial security, in both the case, even if it is a given a gross amount or a net amount, the same must be grossed up. The formula for grossing up is gross interest income is equal to net interest income into 100 divided by 90. Here, usually the students get confused to identify whether it is a government security or non-government security, whether it is a tax-free commercial security or less tax commercial security. So please try to understand. First, you please be thorough with the list which is listed in the 10 of 15. Yendan the securities la section 10 of subsection 15 la list out panirukanganu paathukonga. Adhil arundhu interest income varada problem la kuduthirundhangana adai edukave venda, adhi exempted income. Government security eppadi kandupidikalam appadina the word government will be there. கொடுக்கப்பட்டிருக்க செக்யூரிட்டி பேரில் கவர்மெண்ட்டுன்ற வார்த்தை இருக்கும். அப்படி இருந்ததுன்னா அது கவர்மெண்ட் செக்யூரிட்டி, அதை நீங்கள் கிராஸ் அப் பண்ண வேண்டாம். நீங்கள் தான் இன்ட்ரெஸ்ட்டை கால்குலேட் பண்ணி எடுக்கிறதா இருந்தாலும் சரி, இல்லை இன்ட்ரெஸ்ட் அமௌண்ட்டை கொடுத்துட்டாங்கனாலும் சரி, அதை கிராஸ் அப் பண்ணாமல் அப்படியே போடலாம். அண்ட் நான் கவர்மெண்ட் செக்யூரிட்டியை பொறுத்த வரைக்கும் டேக்ஸ் ஃப்ரீ லெஸ் டேக்ஸ். டேக்ஸ் ஃப்ரீன்ற வேர்டு இருக்கும், அப்படி இருந்ததுன்னா அது டாக்ஸ் ஃப்ரீ கமர்ஷியல் செக்யூரிட்டி. ஆனால் லெஸ் டாக்ஸ் கமர்ஷியல் செக்யூரிட்டியில் லெஸ் டாக்ஸ்ன்ற வார்த்தை இருந்தாலும் இருக்கலாம், இல்லைனா இல்லாமலும் இருக்கலாம். எந்த செக்யூரிட்டிஸ்லாம் கவர்மெண்ட்டுன்ற வார்த்தையும் இல்லாமல் டாக்ஸ் ஃப்ரீன்ற வார்த்தையும் இல்லாமல் இருந்ததோ அது கண்டிப்பாக லெஸ் டாக்ஸ் கமர்ஷியல் செக்யூரிட்டிஸ். இன்னொரு விஷயம் நீங்கள் நோட் பண்ணணும், கவர்மெண்ட் செக்யூரிட்டிஸ்லேயும் டாக்ஸ் ஃப்ரீ கவர்மெண்ட் செக்யூரிட்டிஸ்ன்னு இருக்கும். அந்த டாக்ஸ் ஃப்ரீயை நீங்கள் அந்த இடத்துல பார்க்க வேண்டாம், கவர்மெண்ட் செக்யூரிட்டி அப்படின்னு அதை ட்ரீட் பண்ணிக்கணும். தீஸ் ஆர் த செக்யூரிட்டிஸ் கிவன் அண்டர் செக்ஷன் 10 ஆஃப் சப்செக்ஷன் 15. எனி இன்ட்ரெஸ்ட் அரைவ்ட் ஃப்ரம் தீஸ் செக்யூரிட்டிஸ் ஆர் கம்ப்ளீட்லி எக்ஸம்ப்டட் இன் கம்ப்யூட்டேஷன் ஆஃப் இன்ட்ரெஸ்ட் இன்கம் எக்ஸப்ட் போஸ்ட் ஆஃபீஸ் சேவிங்ஸ் பேங்க் அக்கௌண்ட் ஃபார் விச் த இன்ட்ரெஸ்ட் அப் டு 3,500 இஸ் எக்ஸம்ப்டட். எனி இன்ட்ரெஸ்ட் on post office savings bank account exceeding rupees 3,500 will be chargeable under IFOS. Same way, public account of post office saving account for which interest up to rupees 5,000 is exempted and the amount exceeding 5,000 will be treated as taxable. Income under IFOS continues. Interest on bank deposit is taxable under IFOS. Here the TDS is 10% and TDS will be deducted by the bankers only if the interest income exceeds rupees 10,000. Income by maintenance of horses for race. If an SSC obtain an income on maintenance of horses for race, then the income will be treated under taxable under IFOS, in which the expenditure related to horse maintenance can be deducted. Income by letting of plant and machinery. Any income gained out of letting of plant and machinery, such income will be treated as taxable under the head IFOS. An expenditure related to maintenance of such plant and machinery, such as depreciation, insurance premium, repairs, can be deducted from the same income. Royalty income, any expenditure related to writing of books or patent development etc. can be deducted from such income. Income through family pension, if an SSC receives a family pension, that will be treated as an income under the head IFOS, from which the standard deduction can be deducted, that is 1/3 of family pension received or rupees 15,000, whichever is less, is allowable deduction. Subletting income, if an SSC taken an house for rental basis and if any portion of that house is being given for subletting, any income arising out of it is treated as an income under the head IFOS, from which the expenses related to that portion which has been left for the subletting can be deducted. Other incomes. Salary received by members of parliament is taxable as income from other sources. Any allowances received by member of parliament MLA MPs are completely exempted in computation of income under all the heads. Any cash gift in aggregate and in excess of ₹50,000 received from unrelated person are taxable as IFOS. Cash gift ஒரு வருடத்தில் in aggregate, which means மொத்தமாக வேறு வேறு தேதிகளில் பெறப்பட்ட அந்த கேஷ் கிஃப்டானது அன்ரிலேட்டட் பர்சனாக இருக்கணும், ரிலேட்டிவ் கிட்ட இருந்து இருக்கக்கூடாது. 50,000 தாண்டினால் மொத்தமோ டாக்ஸபிள், அது 50,000 குறைவாக இருந்தால் அனைத்துமே எக்ஸம்ப்டட். கிஃப்ட் ஃப்ரம் ரிலேட்டிவ்ஸ் ஆர் ஃபுல்லி எக்ஸம்ப்டட், கிஃப்ட் ரிசீவ்ட் இன் கைண்ட் ஆர் டாக்ஸபிள். If an assessee purchases an immovable property for a consideration which is less than the stamp duty value of the property by an amount exceeding ₹50,000, stamp duty value of such property as exceeds such consideration shall be taxable under IFOS. Any ground rent received by an assessee is taxable under IFOS. If an assessee is a director of a company, any fee collected for being a director of a company is treated as a taxable income under the head IFOS. Examinership remuneration, if any, received by an assessee is taxable. Any undisclosed income, undisclosed source of income in the hands of assessee will be treated as a taxable income under the head IFOS. Any agriculture income received from outside India is treated as a taxable income under IFOS. Whereas agriculture income received in India is exempted, that we all know. Any other income which are unidentified is also taxable under the head IFOS. Deductions under section 57. This we already discussed along with the income. However, we will see what are all the deductions are eligible under section 57. Bank commission on collection of taxable dividends and interest on securities shall eligible for deduction. Number 2, any interest on loan taken to acquire investment whose income is taxable shall be treated as deductions from such income. Securities எதுலையாவது invest பண்ணுறதுக்காக கடன் வாங்கியிருந்து அதற்கு வட்டி கட்டிட்டு இருந்தாங்கன்னா அந்த வட்டிவானது அவங்களுடைய வருமானத்திலிருந்து கழித்து கொள்ளப்படலாம். அதுதான் அந்த பாயிண்ட்டு. For family pension, a standard deduction under section 52 subsection 2A is available, under which an amount of ₹15,000 or 1/3 of uncommuted pension received, whichever is less, shall be exempt. Depreciation, machinery repairs, then fire insurance premium, local taxes relating to letting of plant and machinery along with building and furniture shall be deducted. Any other expenditure not being a capital expenditure which is expended wholly or exclusively for the purpose of earning such income are exempt under section 57. Here is the model problem with solution. Calculate income from other sources from the following information furnished by Mr. K for the current assessment year. Agriculture income from land situated in India ₹15,000. Agriculture income from land situated in Sri Lanka ₹20,000. Interest on post office savings account ₹6,000. Interest on government securities ₹8,000. Interest on PPF ₹8,500. Dividend from Indian company ₹25,000. Dividend from foreign company ₹18,000. Winning from lottery net ₹35,000. Rent from subletting of a flat ₹12,000. Mr. K has spent ₹3,500 for realizing rent and pays a rent of ₹5,000. Here the solution, and what you have to do, we have to identify each and every income which comes under IFOS. Here all the incomes are taxable in the hands of an assessee under IFOS, and categorize the incomes. First we will take a dividend income. There are two dividend incomes are given. One is from foreign company, the other one is Indian company. And we know dividend from Indian company is completely exempted and dividend from foreign company is taxable. So you put only that 18,000 as a taxable income column. Then interest income. Interest on post office saving, 6,000 is an amount received, whereas up to 3,500 is exempted as per 10 of 15. So after deducting the 3,500, 2,500 will be the taxable income. Interest on government securities, and here we need not to see whether it is gross or a net, because government securities the grossing up is not applicable. So put that 8,000. Then interest on PPF, which is completely exempted, so no need to put any amount. And then casual income, here the only one casual income is given, that is winning from lottery, and in bracket they have given that it is a net amount, so it is to be grossed up. The formula for grossing up is 35,000 into 100 divided by 70, which comes 50,000. Put that 50,000 in the taxable income column. Then subletting income is there, so rent received from subletting amount is 12,000, for which the amount he spent is 3,500 and rent of 5,000. Totally it comes 8,500. Remaining 4,500 will be the taxable income under the in the hands of assessee. Then other incomes, agriculture income is given, and we know agriculture income in India is exempted and agriculture income outside India is taxable, that is of 20,000. The total comes 1,03,000. IFOS is 1,03,000 for Mr. K during the current assessment year. Let me conclude with steps in computation of IFOS. First, from the given problem, select the incomes which are taxable under the head IFOS, categorize the incomes and group it, apply all necessary provisions and deductions, then add all incomes in all different categories to find the taxable income under the head IFOS. Thank you for watching this video.